Hello dear students, welcome in your English class. Before starting today's class, let's see what's the date today. So today's date is 1st March. Okay, and you know from when your annual exam is going to start? Your annual exam is going to start from 5th March. Okay, so only 3-4 days are left for your course revision. Because course is already completed, I think, in all subjects. Only revisions are going on, and now it's your turn to do hard work and proper learning for giving good exam. Okay, let's see today's revision, what we are going to do. So in today's revision, we are going to do the revision of English literature, the chapters which are left. Which are the chapters? Let's see first. So for your annual English literature syllabus, we have 4 chapters, chapter 14, 15, 16 and 19. Okay, and in my previous revision video, we have revised the lesson chapter 14 as well as 15. So revision of these 2 chapters are already done, plus one more revision we have done regarding the vocabs, or you can say the word meanings of all the 4 lessons altogether, which was one more previous video. Okay, I hope you all have revised that word meanings, and I hope you have learned it. Okay, now that means word meanings of all the chapters are revised, as well as we have revised chapter 14 and 15 in our last class. Now in today's class, we are going to revise lesson 16 and 19. What is 16? I float my paper boats. And chapter 19 is what? The Emperor and the Nightingale. I hope both the poem as well as the lessons are clear to you and you have read it thoroughly. Okay. Now, one or two more things I want to discuss in today's class before starting our revision. What's that? Let's see. First of all, you know that your exam will be in MCQ pattern. MCQ pattern means multiple choice pattern. That means multiple questions will be there with multiple answers option, and you have to select it A or B or C or D, like in form of KBC. Okay. So this thing is clear to you, I hope, and you can do it very well, because due to COVID, this whole year you have given the exam in the same pattern. Okay, so no need to worry about the pattern, because it is very much known to you and now you are habitual of giving this type of exam. Okay, now coming to the next topic which I want to discuss is the project submission. I have already given you the project, that was to write the poem. Lesson 16, that is I float my paper boat, on a 5-page, and you have to decorate it and you have to send me. This was your project homework. It was very simple and very easy, as well as I have given you enough time to do it, and I have given the submission dates also, like 15th Feb was the date for 5th A, then 17th was for 5th B, and 18th was for 5th C. But still many students are sending me the project. It's okay, due to some work, some guardians have also called that due to some emergency or some work at home, they couldn't complete the work. It's okay, I am accepting it till date. But still many students are there who has not done the project. This is not good, dear students. You have to do hard work. And this is a homework, a simple poem you have to write. You can't do it. It's very easy. Okay, so please do this work, because your project contains marks and you will lose marks if you will not submit the project timely. Okay, I know the time has gone, but still 4-5 days are left for your exam. Please submit the project. Okay, not only I am talking about English, but in any subject where you have not given the project, please, it's your duty to submit it to the respective teacher. Okay, so these 2 were the important things which I wanted to discuss before starting our revision. Now everyone, let's continue with the revision and take out your Open Skies book. This is your Open Skies book, and open lesson 16. Now what is lesson 16? Lesson 16 is I float my paper boats. Now, what is the name of the poem? I float my paper boats. Who is the poet of the poem? I float my paper boats. The poem is written by Rabindranath Tagore. So the poem is written by Rabindranath Tagore. It can also come as your question. So listen to it very carefully. Now, let's discuss the poem once again and then we will discuss its exercise. Okay. So I float my paper boats. I will read the poem and I will explain it once again. Day by day, I float my paper boats one by one down the running stream. In big black letters, I write my name on them and the name of the village where I live. I hope that someone in some strange land will find them and know who I am. I load my little boats with shiuli flowers from our garden and hope that these blooms of the dawn will be carried safely to land in the night. I launch my paper boats and look up into the sky and see the little clouds setting their wide bulging sails. I know not what playmate of mine in the sky sends them down the air to race with my boats. When night comes, I bury my face in my arms and dream that my paper boats float on and on under the midnight stars. The fairies of sleep are selling in them and the lading is their baskets full of dream. Now, what is the poem all about? The poet is imagining himself as a young boy who used to make paper boats. You know what are paper boats? Paper boats are the boats which you make from the paper that you play. Yes, you make some from papers, you make some boat and you try to float it on a river or any running water, or at home you are filling a bucket of water and you are floating it in. Okay, in it. Okay. Now, what the poet is doing, the poet is making paper boats and he is writing his name as well as his village's name and sailing the paper boat in the running stream. What is the meaning of running stream? Running means the river or the water body is in the moving form. That is, the water is not stagnant. That means the water is not only accumulated at a place. It is in a running form. That means it is moving from one place to another. And the poet is writing his name as well as his village's name on the paper boat. Why? Just to make the paper boat move from his village to another village. And he imagines that anyone living in the other village will get this boat and will see that a boy with this name and he lives in this village. Okay, that means he wants to make a new friend in the other village. And how he will make it, he is doing the work by writing his name as well as his village's name on the boat, so that any other person who receive it on the other village can come to know that a boy with this name is living in this village. Okay, and along with the name, what he is keeping in the paper boat, he is keeping the shiuli flowers. You know what is the shiuli flowers? Shiuli flowers are the night blooming jasmines, or you can say in Hindi we say parijat ka phool, same thing. So this flower blooms at night, and the poet is a Bengali. You know Rabindranath Tagore is a Bengali person, so he is using his mother tongue here. Shiuli is the name of that flower which is used in Bengali. That means Bengali people used to say that night flowering jasmine as shiuli flower. Okay, so from his garden he is plucking those flowers and keeping it in his boat and moving the boat from one village, his village, to any other place through the running stream. Okay, now what happened? This thing is clear. Now what happened? When he is launching his paper boat, launching means to start. When he is ready to sail his boat, he is looking at the sky and he is seeing that the clouds are there and they are ready to have rain, means ready to give rainfall. Okay, so what happened? He is thinking some of my playmate up upon there. Playmate means playmate. Mate means friend. Play means a person with whom we play. That means the friend only for playing purpose. Okay, so I know not what my playmate of mine in the sky sends them down the rain air to race with my boat. That means the poet is imagining that the clouds are raining or sending its rain just to race with his paper boat. When the night comes, I bury my face in my arms and dreams that my paper boats float on and on under the midnight stars. When the night is coming, he is just means burying his face in the arms. Burying means chupa lena. Face ko he is hiding with his arms. Why? And he is imagining that the fairies of the sleep. What are the fairies of the sleep? The what? Angels who carry beautiful dreams in like we say na, so jao nanni pari aa jayegi, like that sort of. So the poet is also imagining that the fairies of the sleep are sailing on that paper boats and going from his village to another village, and the boats are carrying beautiful dreams in that paper boat. This is the imagination of the poet, and by this the poet is means expressing his means you can say his childhood through this poem. Okay, so I hope the poem is once again clear to you. Please read it down carefully. Now let's move on to the exercises. This vocabs we have already discussed. Now let's move to the exercises. Here we have to use suffix or the prefix. What is there? Add suffix fullness, lie, less, or to make new words. This thing we have done. Cheerful, graceful, goodness, helpful, harmful, happiness, or you can write happily, wonderful, merrily, careful or careless, friendly. Okay, these are the words I have dictated so that you can tally your answers if you have written it or not. Now, next part is your question answer. Question answer I will not discuss now. Like in the previous video, what I have done after completing the video, I have sent it the question answer pages on your WhatsApp group so that you can check it out there. So this time also I will do the same thing. I will discuss both the lessons, and after that I am going to send you the question papers pictures so that you can tally your answers. Now turn your page 124. Now it's true or false. The poet is fond of floating paper boats in the running stream. Yes, true. The poet loads his little boats with various kinds of flowers. No, false, because he is loading only with the shivli flower. Next, in his dreams, the poet sees his boats float and on under the midnight stars. Yes, this is true. Now, shivli flower blooms at night. Yes, this is also true because this is the night blooming jasmine. Okay, now let's come to the fill in the blanks part. The poet writes his name and the name of the village on the paper boat. Shivli flower grows in the poet's garden. When night comes, the poet buries his face in his arms. The poet floats his paper boats in the stream. Put a tick on the correct option to complete the sentence. The poet loads his boats with shivli flowers from his garden. That is option 1. After launching his paper boats, he looks up into the sky. That is option 2. Next, third question is, looking into the sky, the poet sees the little clouds setting their white bulging sails. That is option 4. Now, next, the poet thinks that the fairies of sleep are sailing in the boat and the lading is their baskets full of dreams. That is option 3. Okay, so by this we have completed the revision of lesson 16. Now only one lesson is left, that is chapter 19. Open your book, chapter 19. The Emperor and the Nightingale. This is page number 144. See, this is your story, Emperor and the Nightingale. You can pause the video here and you can read the lesson once so that you can recall the whole story. Because I am not going to explain you the story here. Okay, I will just discuss the book exercises. So take your time. You can pause the video and you can read the story. Till then, let me rub the board. I hope, dear students, you have read the lesson, okay, by pausing the video. Now let's start with the exercises. Your exercises start from page number 147, and like all the chapters, you are having the vocabs here. You have to learn the vocabs. This thing I have already mentioned. Now moving to the exercise. So here are certain words are there which we use in pair, like bread and butter, lock and key, nail and hammer. Many words are there which we use in pairs. So here are also some words, and in a pink color box, some other words are given. We have to pair it. Okay. Now let's see. First one is pick and drop. Second, bag and baggage. Third, ups and downs. Fourth, off and on. Buy and sell. Here and there. Hammer and nail. Kith and kin. Okay, so I hope you have done it. Now come to question answer. Same thing, question answer I will not discuss here. I will send you the pics of the question answer so that you can tally your work. Okay, now let's turn the page and move to page number 148. This page. Now comes to true and false. The nightingale lived very happily in the palace. No, false. Because the nightingale was not at all happy. The nightingale lived in a large forest near the palace of the Chinese emperor. Yes, this is true. The third one, the minister gave orders to his men to catch the nightingale. Yes, this is also true. Fourth one, writers come from all parts of India to study the life of this wonderful bird. So this is false. Now more than 1,000 guests came for the party. This is true. Okay, now move to the next exercise, that is third exercise. Complete the sentences with the words from the lesson. A Japanese merchant had brought a wonderful toy bird to the city. Next, I did not want your golden cage or your golden collar, said the nightingale. Third, all birds must die like all other living things. At last, the nightingale in the forest heard of the emperor's illness. Okay. Next, the last one in the fill in the blanks is, after some days, the dashing toy bird broke and its song stopped. What broke? The machine. The machine of the toy bird broke. Okay. Now, put a tick on the correct option to complete the sentence. Excuse me. The nightingale was unhappy because it was not free. The emperor asked the minister to buy the toy bird because the minister said that real birds die, toy birds don't. Third, the emperor sat on the golden throne, and in front of the throne was hung a golden cage. That is first option. Next, D one is, the nightingale stayed in the emperor's palace because it was kept locked in a cage. Okay. Next, all the travelers who visited China praised this nightingale because it sang wonderfully. Okay. So by this we have completed our revision for English literature. Okay. Now, Monday, today is Monday's class. So, we have 2-3 more classes. On Tuesday, we are going to revise with the grammar section. Okay. So, thank you students. Have a nice day. Keep learning. Okay. And I will send you the question answers right now. Please check your answers. If you have any problem, you can ask me between 1 to 2 p.m. at my WhatsApp number. And yes, one more thing. Please send the projects those who have not sent. Okay, this is not good. Please, dear students, please do hard work. Okay, thank you and have a nice day. Keep learning.